Painter Lila Cola Weeks feels technology is changing something fundamental about ourselves.
In some ways, I'm attempting to bridge these two worlds within visual art: abstraction and representation. There's something really powerful about drawing from both pools. To bring them together leads to that much more possibility. And I think possibility is a really important word when we talk about surrealism, because it sheds light on what might not always have been thought to be possible. It brings things into being which would not have otherwise been able to come into being.
Where do you find your subject matter?
I think my subject matter comes to me in flashes of inspiration. I'll be thinking about the world we live in and what it feels like, and certain imagery might just pop into my mind as seeming like powerful as a symbol. Can't help but notice how quickly our day-to-day human experience seems to have changed. I stand at a unique vantage point with my age. You know, there are people alive today who spent most of their lives without digital technology being a part of it, and it came into their lives much later, and so maybe it was foreign for them. There are also people alive today who were born, say, after the year 2000, who can't remember a time in which cell phones and tablets and social media weren't the norm. I feel like I'm at the top of a peak, and I can kind of look down on both sides and see this kind of phenomenon that's really quickly come upon us and changes our day-to-day experience. It changes how we communicate with each other. And it seems like applications of digital technology ends up reducing human interaction. And that seems sort of strange. It seems like we're changing something fundamental about ourselves in this very moment.
And how do symbols represent this?
I guess I'm using the symbols that are also being used by technology, but I'm sort of bringing them into this different space and using them as tools of commentary or tools of witnessing. We use a mouse cursor often. Many people have a desktop computer and use a mouse to navigate around through that space. Something that we also take for granted. You can see it and not see it all at once, both when you're using it on your screen or when you see it on a painting, even though it's out of context. There's something so strange to me about that, I guess, that we've taken this foreign thing, this little mouse cursor symbol, and we've absorbed it fully. Just a few years of using it, it's almost become part of us.
Can you tell us a little bit about feeling small and large all at once?
Sometimes I like to think about myself as a human in the universe and how very small that feels. And it's humbling. And then I like to think about myself as a being comprised of tiny parts, and that makes the whole self feel huge. I like dancing back and forth between those two feelings. At the time, I was thinking a lot about technology and the changing world we live in. There's a face, and it's wearing a mask, a symbol about communication and the changing communication. And for instance, when we are texting each other, there is a human on the other end, but there's a lot that you miss. It's not a face-to-face interaction. All of this musculature that ends up carrying a lot of meaning is hidden. And there's a lot of subtlety, I guess, that gets lost. It's powerful. It changes our experience of the world.
What, in your opinion, is the role or the work of the artist?
If I imagine a world that there wasn't art to be a part of our experience, to me that is a really dismal prospect. On the one hand, artists contribute something that's valuable to society, and it's partially about creating commentary and engaging in dialogue. It's also partially about standing for the freedom to create something that which isn't functional, or say purely functional. It's almost about play, you know, aesthetics and beauty. It's hard to ascribe value to them, except we know that they are deeply valuable. The role of the artist is sort of, on the one hand, quite altruistic. On the other hand, it's also really selfish. There's something that is really necessary, almost. Painting, it's the most useful and successful tool of my own inner peace. I think I do both, you know, get to help myself and hopefully give a small gift to my fellow man.